There's lots and lots of people who still believe that the moon landing didn't actually happen. And I kind of feel like we should get to the bottom of this and see if we can recreate the moon landing, then maybe there's a possibility that that could have actually been done on a sound stage back in 1969.
That's right, from the lunar surface. Come now, you can see the moon from the lunar surface. Beautiful, just beautiful.
There's lots of compelling evidence that the moon landing did happen. And there's actually a lot of compelling evidence that maybe the moon landing was staged.
So I've actually done a lot of research on this.
Going into your research, what were some of your doubts that it happened?
And I was confused about how they filmed it. Like if they were just stepping out, who put the camera there? Mm-hmm. But they have that completely like documented. There was this guy, Stan LaBar, who invented a camera that was in the side of the lunar module. When Neil Armstrong was stepping out, he like pulled a lever that flipped it open, and that's how they got his steps.
Sure, they filmed it, but to broadcast it live from the moon, like that seems pretty difficult, especially using slow scan television, which is like one image for each frame of video that they had to then send to Australia, which then had to be changed into broadcast format.
If there's no wind on the moon, right? How come the flag is blowing in the wind?
Inertia, which is the force of like once an object is in motion, it mm-hmm. remains in motion. So from the force of them putting it into the ground, that's where the movement comes from. And there wasn't like gravity or force in the atmosphere to like stop it.
A lot of people think that there was a version that was filmed just in case they weren't able to make it to the moon or land on the moon.
So it makes sense that they'd have a backup plan because we had to show that we actually landed on the moon. We had to beat the Russians.
Yeah. Do you guys want to get down to the bottom of this or what?
Yeah,
let's do it.
The day has come, we're gonna recreate the moon landing on this awesome soundstage. We got a pulley rope system hooked up. We have the harness, which is gonna be used to pull me up like I'm on the moon's landscape, and it's gonna be awesome. How do we keep the flag like in the motion that it looks like in the video?
Wire with a little bit of fan.
We got our flag right here, which will simulate anti-gravity. It's time to create the landscape of the moon.
I think just piling dirt is not gonna work mm-hmm. just because we're not gonna get the detail and the shadows just from dirt. So what I'd like to do is still get some dirt and sand, but put it strategically in places and then use pieces of like rock foam.
Anything that we do end up having to do in post-production, we're gonna try to do as accurately to what tools they had available at the time. Mm-hmm. So we're not gonna use any CGI, we're only gonna use very simple compositing tricks that are similar to what they would have been able to do at the time using front projection, which is what a lot of experts think was used to fake the footage. We're gonna try to extend the surface in post to make it feel like there's much bigger moon surface here.
Okay, so we got the astronaut NASA suits right in here. This is about to be the ultimate unboxing video. Are you ready?
I'm so excited. Whoa.
Here's my oxygen pack so I can breathe in fake space.
That's super legit.
So I'm getting suited up right now. They're making sure I'm super safe and that I don't break any legs. I feel like the bell of the ball. Oh my God.
I think this is gonna work.
I don't know if this is gonna work.
I think the point will get across.
Okay, I'm just gonna kind of bounce around and just do it.
Oh my God.
Hey, Ricky, I think you want to move like you're in Jell-O.
Yeah, like move you're in slow.
Like you're in slow motion, kind of.
Slow.
Yeah.
It just takes a second. Okay.
Yeah, that's good.
So since we don't actually have two astronauts, we're going to take Ricky here. And we've already filmed him once doing the kind of floating motion, and now we're going to film him again on the other side of the flag as the second astronaut, and then we'll composite them together with a split screen.
Cool.
Cool. Let's do it. It's going a little bit too fast. Yeah, now you look like you're in space. What I'm doing right now is compositing using digital versions of the same techniques that would have been available to filmmakers at the time.
Yes, indeed. They've got the flag up now, and you can see the stars and stripes on the limit.